definition of each country, because in the case of the broader African continent, you have a situation where South Africa seems to be attracting everyone. The rest of the economies have basically collapsed. The reasons are known. The neoliberal policies in the rest of the continent, you can go to Tanzania, you go to Zambia, you go to Zimbabwe and other countries, Nigeria, that implemented neoliberal policies. In Zimbabwe, you call it Economic Structural Adjustment Program. Here in South Africa, you call it GIA, in 1996. Now, if everyone comes to South Africa, it means there's contestation of resources in communities. When there's contestation of resources in communities, there is bound to be violence, because they are basically competing for these resources. So there's bound to be violence, which we saw in the past. Particularly at this stage, post-COVID economy, where we are told that, for instance, in the restaurant industry, the hospitality industry, 30 to 40% restaurants did not open after lockdown, when the country was placed on lockdown level 5. We see what is happening in the freight industry. We see the strategies between the migrant workers and what we term the South African workers. We see the exploitation of the employer. If you study carefully, the violence that broke out in Isipimo, in Durban, in 2015, the reasons were being that workers went on strike. The employer then went to look for migrant labor force, which was exploiting, and violence started. So why it's important to speak in what Comrade Chair will call the reunion agenda, to say, as Dr. Elgon has already elaborated, that the creation of these colonial boundaries or borders divided families. You have got the people of Botswana, in Botswana on the other side of South Africa, same with Basotho in Lesotho on the other side, in Swaziland, same thing, Venda in Zimbabwe on the other side of South Africa. You go to Zambia, you have the Tonga across the Zambia on Zimbabwe side, same thing in Zimbabwe, Botswana. So you have families that have been split up through these borders. But what is key in terms of a question is that as we open these borders, there must be economic development in all of these countries. We should not be opening borders where the influx is into one country. We must have a situation where a South African will go and want to go and live in Lusaka to say, I send sugar a KZN, says Yatala and Lusaka, because you like the climate, you like the weather. But if everyone comes to South Africa, you are going to have conflict. So the question that we're confronted with as Africans is the whole question of industrialization, a rebuilding of our economies. Why are our economies collapsing? Why do we have a collapsed economy, say, in Zimbabwe, where 90% of the workforce is in the informal sector, where young people, when they finish writing their exams, the only place they think of to go and look for employment is Johannesburg. Same thing in Swaziland, same thing in DRC, and now it's going beyond SADC. But you also have, which might come to the last point, question number two, probably, the issue of the conflict which we see in Mozambique. Again, in line with the African Union agenda to say, let's silence the guns, because indeed you have economic migrants that are flocking to South Africa. You also have people that are being persecuted in their own countries who are running away from the conflict. So in summary, in conclusion, two things must happen. One, we must rebuild our economies in the continent. Two, we must silence the guns so that all of us will live in peace. Thank you, Comrade Chair. Amen.
Thank you.